The Automated Fodder System, or AFS, is a totally automated hydroponic system that plants the seed into trays, provides the optimum conditions for growth, harvests the sprouted grain, and cleans the tray after harvest. Also, the system will manage the environment, water the crop, provide nutrients to the crop, and provide data for the administrative use. Should any parameters become unbalanced, the system will notify the facility personnel. The process is normally a 6 or 7 day seed-to-feed crop of hydroponically sprouted grain. Barley is the grain of choice due to its high protein content. The process starts by filling a hopper with grain and water to soak. A series of grain bins will hold the barley seed awaiting use. These bins are located outside and will hold 32 tons of grain. At startup of the facility, the soak tank at each unit is filled with water and then seed. The soak tank is mounted on load cells so that the correct amount of water and seed can be added to the soak tank. The seed will absorb 25% of additional weight from the soaking process, and the germination will gain 1 day of growing time. At the same time, air will be bubbled through the soak tank to further aerate the water. The time that the soaking starts is variable and is based on the time that the harvest is desired. The seed soak time is 5 hours, but may vary depending on the variety of seed use. Reseeding will occur after the machine has been harvested. Once the trays have been planted, the trays will automatically be stored in the storage area of the machine. There, the crop is watered, nutrients applied, and lighting and airflow are provided. This layer of trays will sit like this for 6 days. The harvest process starts when two criteria are met. The first is that the crop has met its 6 days of growth. The second is when a truck and driver have parked outside under the discharge conveyor and the driver has indicated how much fodder is required. The system always knows how much fodder has been provided and how much is available to be provided for each day. The harvest process consists of the elevator on the machine moving to the harvest level for that day and removes a tray from the correct storage area. Each machine requires about 45 minutes to harvest all of its daily trays, which on the 5,000-pound machine is 2 levels, each with 30 trays. The elevator then moves to harvest level and dumps the fodder onto a harvest conveyor where it is weighed. Once the tray has been dumped, it is run through a washing process where the tray is washed and scrubbed and then placed onto a storage level. After the layer has been harvested, the machine goes into a seeding cycle. The seeding cycle has already begun when the soak tank was filled. At this time, the soak tank drain valve will automatically be activated, and the unabsorbed water will be drained from the tank. This water can be captured and is called rejuvelet. After the water has been drained off, the seed is automatically placed into a discharge hopper. The elevator system moves to the storage level and retrieves an empty tray to be filled. The elevator then moves to the seeding level where the tray is to be seeded. The soak tank drains into a discharge hopper. which drops the seed evenly onto the waterfall conveyor that moves over the tray to evenly fill them. The tray, once filled, is then elevated to the correct growing level, where it is stored for growth. One of the major components of this entire system is controlling the environment. The intent is to provide an environment similar to ideal growing conditions outdoors. The conditions are continuously monitored, and if any of them remain out of balance, the maintenance personnel are automatically notified via text. The conditions monitored are temperature, humidity, dew point, CO2 level, airflow, lighting intensity, and light color. Readily available industry standard American-made equipment is used for all of the components except for the LED lighting. All controlling is done by a standard Allen Bradley PLC. The entire machine is made from stainless steel to allow a long life expectancy.